This is a case where we have a reaction taking place and KO2 and CO2 react, and the vessel is sealed, so it's a fixed volume, and we're given the initial pressure, and we want to know the final pressure after the reaction goes to completion, namely after 28 grams have reacted. So the important things that we want to use, the volume, 8.90 liters, and the initial pressure, let's call that pressure 1.009 bar. And the question is the final pressure. So pressure 2, we don't know. That's what we're trying to determine. So 28 grams of KO2, we need to determine how many moles that is, because what's happening during reaction is, as far as the gas phase is concerned, and that's what determines the pressures, we have 2 moles of gas reacting to 3 moles of gas. And so this change in the number of moles of gas, since we're keeping it at constant temperature, this change in number of moles of gas is going to cause the pressure to increase. But we need to know how many moles react, because this is 2 moles going to 3 for every 4 moles of this potassium oxide. So let's look up the values. We need the atomic weights, potassium and oxygen. So now we can get the molecular weight of KO2. It's 39.10 plus 2 times 16. So we have now the molecular mass of our reactant. And so 71.10 grams per mole. And we know that there's an increase in, for every 4 moles of KO2 that react, we have one additional mole of gas. 4 moles react, that requires 2 moles of CO2, and we end up with 3 moles of oxygen. So this number then will give us the number of moles of additional gas. And then should be able to use the ideal gas law to determine the pressure. So I've calculated the moles of additional gas, and the question is, what additional pressure will that cause? So we can think of that gas being in the container by itself. What additional pressure would it exert? That's the pressure we'd add on to our original pressure. So again, if we look at ideal gas law, the pressure then is the number of moles. And the gas constant we'll look up, and we're going to use units of bar and liter, mole, Kelvin. And then the temperature is 273.2 plus 22, to put it in Kelvin. So 295.2 Kelvin. And the volume is 8.90 liters. So let's look up the gas constant. So we put in the gas constant, we check the units, and we end up with pressure in bar. So this then would be the pressure increase. We want to know the final pressure. Well, the initial pressure, so the final pressure then 1.280 bar. That's the final pressure in the container.